Howdy folks, and welcome back to Armored Warfare with the Mighty Jingles, and today it's all about the epic fail. Some of it my fault, some of it not. I finally unlocked my first tier 8 vehicle in Armored Warfare. Actually, I have two of them. The first one I unlocked was the M109A6 Paladin tier 8 self-propelled gun. I've actually got two tier 8s in Armored Warfare now. I was playing a lot of it over my Christmas break, and my other tier 8 is the other tier 8 artillery you have. The Panzer H2000. Look, don't judge me. I enjoy playing artillery in Armored Warfare. But I am catching up with the main battle tanks and the light tanks. Well, not so much the light tanks, but the tank destroyers. And particularly the armored fighting vehicles. I've been having a lot of fun with those as well. And I've got some great games to show you. Particularly in this little thing here, the VBL. Which is an absolute blast to play. But the focus of today's video is the epic fail, and in order to do that, we're going to have to take you back to one of the very first games I played in the M109 Paladin. Almost a completely stock machine. I had none of the speciality ammunition researched. I didn't have the smoke rounds. In particular, I didn't have the illumination rounds. I had nothing, just 152mm high explosive. And I got the Operation Scorpio map, which is not a bad map for artillery. In fact, that's one of the good things about the PvE missions in Armored Warfare. You can actually see what mission is coming up next. So if you get a map, and this is going to be of particular importance later on in today's video, by the way, if you get a map that is not suitable for the class of vehicle which you intend to use, then just pick another vehicle or wait for a different map to pop up in the rotation. Operation Scorpio, not a bad map for artillery. You can be very, very useful to your team if you pick a self-propelled gun on this map. Now, we did have a bit of an uphill struggle on this match, and the reason for that is because I'm in a self-propelled gun, a mostly stock self-propelled gun, on tier 8, and I'm top tier. Almost everybody else in this match on my team is a very thinly armored vehicle. They're either an armored fighting vehicle, or they're a wheeled tank destroyer. We have one main battle tank, and he's only tier 6. The matchmaking for main battle tanks in Armored Warfare co-op missions can be pretty brutal. It's not unusual to see a two-tier spread. So if you're at tier 6, for example, T-72, and you're the only main battle tank on our team, and you're in a tier 8 match, because I'm here in a tier 8 self-propelled gun, I am going to drag this T-72 into matches where he's going to be facing tier 9 AI. And that's not going to be easy. And he's the only tank on our team with any kind of armor. Right now, I'm being counter-batteried. Didn't see where the shot came from. The M109, by the way, is a single-shot artillery. It's not like the Panzer H2000. It's not like the Palmaria at tier 6 or the Akatsir at tier 6. There's the artillery. There he is. No, he isn't. That's not the artillery. Where is he? There he is. Right. I'm going to get one shot off. He's been spotted. Bingo. Took him out. Wouldn't have had the firepower to take him out by myself in one shot. For that, you really need something like the Panzer H2000. Although it can't do it in one shot, it can do it in one salvo. It's an auto-loading artillery, like the Palmaria at tier 6, and like the Akatsir, also at tier 6. The M109 Paladin, not. Single shot. And it does more damage with that one shot, and it has a bigger splash radius, but it doesn't do enough damage to one shot an enemy artillery. So this whole counter-battery thing with the Paladin, it can be a bit tricky, especially if there's more than one AI artillery on the map. But in this particular case, it wasn't so bad. There was only one enemy Paladin. I took a small hit from him. I don't think it was a direct hit. And he got spotted when he was firing anyway, and I was assisted in taking him out by the rest of the team. But it's going to be a severe uphill struggle for the rest of the team when they're going up against things like these Leopard 2s. And they've got 30mm of armour, or they're in a Tier 6 T-72. I really, really need to step up my game here and make my presence felt as the Tier 8 on the team. And I didn't really have much trouble doing that. Scorpio is a good map for it, as long as your team can stay alive. The trick, of course, is going not for those targets that you can kill easily. It's going for those targets that your team can't kill easily. So wherever possible, I'm going for the high-tier main battle tanks. I'm not going to get as much damage done as I could, but there's no point in shooting at the light tanks and the armored fighting vehicles. My team can kill those. It's machines like this that they're going to struggle with, and I can hit them, so that's my job. It does frustrate me when you see the artillery going for those lightly armoured vehicles that have less than 100 health left, when sitting right next to them is a Leopard 2A6 with his frontal armour towards the rest of your team's guns, and they just can't penetrate him from the front. The artillery can do damage to them. Land a hit on the engine deck, you might set them on fire. And instead, well, you know what players are like in multiplayer games. And no, crap, I've been spotted. Who spotted me? Who spotted me? Occasionally there's a respawn, by the way, which I believe we're going to see later on in this mission. An artillery respawn right... Oh, crap, that T-72. Yes, there it is. Artillery spawned right next to me. That's what spotted me. And I've taken a hit. And it's not enough to kill him. Help! Yes. Did they get him? I think they did. No, they didn't. I've taken another bloody hit. There he is. Right. Can I finish him in two shots? Yes, I can. Okay. Right. Took a lot of damage there. But the artillery respawn has been taken care of. I should be left alone, provided my team can stay alive. And they've done a very, very good job of actually not dying so far. Again, there's a really big tank that my team are going to have problems dealing with, so better if I could land a direct hit on him. And of course, if I had the speciality ammunition, the support rounds unlocked, the star shell, for example, I could light these guys up. T-72's in serious trouble. He needs my help. And I can't hit him. I can't hit him, but I can hit him. And the T-72 won't be able to penetrate him from the front. Oh, look at all of these guys going for that T-72. Hold on, dude. I'm doing what I can. You worry about the ones in front of you, I'll cover your flank. Well, you know, as best I can. This thing doesn't load very quickly. And again, they've disappeared. But... yes, that was a hit. T-72 is still hanging on by the skin of his teeth. Come on. I'll cover your flank. You just get yourself safe. Oh, it was a good hit. But he's gone. T-72 doesn't want to risk coming out and taking a shot in the flank to spot them, so I've pretty much done all I can for that guy. Nothing else to shoot at the moment. Okay, good. Team took him out. Ah, there we go. That's a much better target. He's about to disappear. Some damage. Crippled some of his modules. I can't drop smoke for the team, I can't illuminate targets for the team, it's just a question of doing as much damage as I can. I think we've just lost the T-72. Yeah. That was pretty inevitable. This is where it all starts going horribly wrong. With the T-72 gone, all we have left is a BMD-4, which is an armoured fighting vehicle and has tinfoil for armour, and a Centauro, which is a wheeled tank destroyer and has tinfoil for armour. Now, they can do a lot of damage. They can't take a lot of damage. And they can only do a lot of damage to a machine like that Challenger 2 if they get his sides or rear, and they don't have his sides or rear. So if you are playing artillery in a match like this, go for the targets like the main battle tanks that have their front pointing towards the guns on your team. You can see that somebody's firing high explosive at that guy. They only did about 48 damage. I can do some serious damage to these guys. In fact, I might even be able to kill this one. Nope. No, unfortunately he moved. And now the Challenger 2 is out of my line of fire. But I should be able to reload in time to nail. If I can predict where he's going to be. Fired blind. Didn't kill him, but did some damage. I can hit the Challenger 2 from here. Oh, he's given his side. Come on, guys. Let's go for the engine. And I've set him on fire. That's what we needed. Come on. Come on. Don't move. Don't move. Stay there. Stay there. The team can't afford to take another hit. Come on. Yep, hit him again. Not enough to kill him. But you can see from the damage report that popped up, I have completely immobilized him. And there he is. He's been spotted again. He's got his tracks back up, and there's another, and he's been immobilized again. There's all kinds of module damage to this guy. I can kill this Challenger too. The team can't. Come on. Come on. Yes, got him. And we've lost the Centauro. oh, great. So there's just me and the BMD-4. And unfortunately, we have to cap. So, yeah. Shit just got real. the BMD... I'm not going to be the one to cap. The BMD's going to have to do it. I mean, the cap circle's right there. Oh, hang on, I can kill this T-80. Shots out, that's a guaranteed kill. Let's get back onto this Leopard 2. You see, the problem here is the BMD is going to have to cap, and we do not have a lot of time in which to do it. Now, if I'd managed to unlock the smoke shells, we could have won this relatively easily. Pops into the cap circle. There he goes. I drop smoke, and I just keep dropping smoke, and we wait out the timer. But I haven't unlocked the smoke shells yet, because this is, if not my first, my second game in this machine. And so the AI now know exactly where he is. And here comes the M1A2 Abrams. So I start putting shots out. The BMD takes a hit, survives it, gets the flank of the Abrams, and he actually kills him. Good boy. But he's not going to survive another hit. I need to nail this BMPT Terminator. He disappears, he's not spotted anymore, but I do score. I think that was a direct hit. Knocked out his commander's cupola and crippled a couple of modules. But Leopard 2, on the far side of the valley, starts taking the BMD under fire after the BMPT spotted him. I score a decent hit on the Leopard 2, but then the BMPT and numerous other enemy tanks crest the ridge, and there's just no way the BMD was going to survive that. So now I'm the last one left alive on my team. And I have to cap. it's just not going to happen, is it? I start making a move, and then I look at the timer, and no. There is just no way. We cannot win this match. And this is the most damage I have ever done when playing artillery in Armored Warfare. And if you haven't played Armored Warfare, that may surprise you. You tend to do far less damage in artillery than any other class of vehicle. Even the armored fighting vehicles with their little 20 and 30 millimeter autocannons. It just does not do a lot of damage. Well, I mean, I've done 11,700 damage in this match, which would be a reasonable amount of damage for a tier 8 main battle tank. Well, actually, it would be an okay, a barely acceptable amount of damage for a tier 8 battle tank. But it's a ridiculous amount of damage to do in a tier 8 artillery. Why did we lose that match? We lost that match because the matchmaker only gave us one main battle tank. And the main battle tank that it gave us was only tier 6, and it was a tier 8 match with tier 9 enemies. There was very little chance from the beginning that we were ever going to pull this one off. And yet we could still have done it if I hadn't had a stock paladin. And I'd at least unlocked the smoke rounds. I could have shielded the T-72 when he was being pressed from all sides and kept him alive for a little bit longer. I could have shielded the BMD-4 when he was trying to cap in the cap circle, but I didn't have it unlocked. And so that's the most damage I have ever done in any artillery in Armored Warfare, and it was a horrible, horrible defeat. So, Jingles, what was it exactly that prompted you to do an epic fail compilation in Armored Warfare today? This match is the reason I thought, I know what video I'm going to do for tomorrow. This time, we've got a top-tier main battle tank, and it's the mighty Challenger. So, while the team does still only have one main battle tank, it's a Challenger, and it's top-tier, and that makes a big, big difference. This tank has a metric arse-ton of health, very strong frontal armor, and while the gun's good, but it's not great. It does reliable, consistent damage. It certainly doesn't do the kind of damage that you get from the Soviet guns. And the ammunition choice is very, very simple in the Challenger, because you only really get two kinds of ammunition. You get HESH, which is all but useless, and you get APFSDS, which does not do a huge amount of damage, but it's accurate, it's consistent. The penetration isn't great, but you can certainly snipe weak spots with it, and if anybody gives you the side, you can kill them. And that's the thing. One of the major differences between Armored Warfare and World of Tanks is tactics that World of Tanks players take for granted, like side scraping, in order to maximize the effectiveness of their frontal armor. It's not that side scraping doesn't work in Armored Warfare, it does, but the penetration of the guns is so great that if you side scrape more than 10 degrees, you're going to get your side armor overmatched and penetrated. The difference in protection between your frontal armor on a main battle tank and your side and rear armor on a main battle tank in a modern main battle tank is so great. Check this guy out. Here we go, a Leopard 2. There's nowhere I can penetrate this guy. Maybe his driver's hatch. So instead, I'll take a shoot at the light. A shot at the light tank beside him. And sure enough, he gives him the side. If that had been a Tiger II, for example, in World of Tanks, that would probably have bounced off the side armor with that, say, 30 degrees of side scraping. It's a recipe for disaster here in Armored Warfare, and that's just a factor of how much more powerful the guns are and how much more armor these machines have at the front compared to the sides. Not lacking for targets at the moment, and the team are doing all right. This was not a bad team. I really don't like those things. Unless they give you the side, the only place you can penetrate is the driver's hatch right there. I mean, you can hit the missile launcher on the top, but it's an unmanned section of the vehicle, so you're going to do a fraction of the damage potential of your shot. Nevertheless, the Challenger is accurate enough that you can reliably hit that driver's viewport. There we go. I can penetrate the side of that Leopard 2 at that kind of angle. He's not giving me an awful lot of the side, but he's given me enough. Our BMP-3 has designated him as a target. What that means, and I've killed him, which is nice, that's the class ability of the Armored Fighting Vehicle class here in Armored Warfare. If a target gets designated by an Armored Fighting Vehicle, anybody who hits and penetrates that target, and the target will remain visible regardless of line of sight, and anybody who hits and penetrates that target while they have been lit up, you do the full damage range of whatever the damage range of your gun is. So if, for example, your gun would normally do... Oh, there's the artillery. Hey, and I've killed him as well. So if your gun would normally do 400 to 500 damage, if the target's been illuminated by an armored fighting vehicle, your gun will do 500 damage, providing you penetrate. Now, the first wave of this particular co-op battle, Operation Perseus, is not too tricky. The AI is not particularly intelligent. There's the other artillery. I don't quite have the gun depression. The team are going to take him out. Fine, no problem. The first spawn is not particularly tricky. The second spawn... Oh, and I've had my tracks blown off, but that's fine. I don't care. Shoot at me, not my team. I'm the main battle tank, and I can take it. The second spawn can be a little problematic. Again, it's not too difficult to kill them, providing you've got tanks in the correct positions. And you take advantage of getting some side shots on all the main battle tanks that spawn over here before they get into the cap circle. And I can keep doing this all day in the Challenger. Front towards the enemy, loads of health, loads of armor, and I've got flanking shots into all of these guys as they move around to try to get into the cap. With any luck, they're going to be shooting at me rather than anybody else on my team. Unfortunately, things could be a bit better for two reasons. While they're certainly not bad, and I am certainly capable of killing these guys before the next objective pops up, with a little bit of support from the team, but we've lost the ERC-90F4. Okay, he's only tier 5, he only has a 90mm gun, but even that 90mm gun can do a lot of damage to these machines, shooting them in the flank. Unfortunately, he's dead. Also, have a look at where our Stingray's gone. Do you see him there on the map? I'll just point it out for you. What the hell is he doing over there? He's run off to where the final objective of Operation Perseus is going to be, and in doing so, he's triggered a spawn of enemy vehicles, and he is now having to deal with a bunch of tier 8 and 9 main battle tanks all by himself. We can't support him over there. If we do drive all the way over there to support him, we're going to lose because these tanks are going to cap. And while I can kill these tanks, I'm going to run out of ammunition doing it because there's just me and the BMP-3 shooting at them. I'm not even sure the VFM-5 can hit these guys from where he is. It looks like he's rushed off over there to try to get some shots and assist the Stingray, who appears to just be cowering in the bushes at the bottom end of that peninsula, terrified of what he's just stirred up. And then I get set on fire. Always, always pack a fire extinguisher on the Challenger. In fact, sometimes you may wish you'd packed two. And this is where things start to get a little complicated. Because there's just me and the BMP shooting at these guys, I've now almost expended my ammunition, but these guys have not yet finished spawning. There's 1 minute left of this particular wave. I've now got 10 rounds of ammunition left. That's not going to be enough to deal with the third wave. It's not going to be enough to finish dealing with this wave. The Stingray's dead. We could have really used that Stingray's gun over here, but no, he had to go and do a John Wayne miles away from the objective, spawn a whole bunch of tanks that he was completely incapable of dealing with, splitting the team apart as the VFM-5 went over too late to try to back him up, which just left me and the BMP-3 over here trying, and now the VFM's just been taken out as well, so it's just me and the BMP-3 trying to finish these guys off in the next 20 seconds, because they don't just keep spawning from over there. There's always a couple that pop up here behind you. And I could really have done without this. I'm down to single digit figures ammunition here. I'm getting some help from the BMP-3, and the BMP-3 is a good vehicle. And he did at least stick with me. And I've managed to get the front of the tank turned around, so I'm not too concerned about this light tank. Unfortunately, that BMPT Terminator's now got my arse. Luckily, however, well, he's more interested in killing the BMP-3 than me. Well, that's lucky for me. It's not lucky for the BMP-3. And I've had to burn my consumable, which is PvE only, replenishes some of your hit points, and reloads all of your ammunition. Aiming for the driver's hatch on the BMPT, and unfortunately, I've just lost the BMP-3, and I'm now the last one on my team, while trying to finish off this BMPT. And I've got it. We're now being capped, and have been for quite some time. But first, I've got to get to the cap circle. It really didn't help that that Stingray triggered that spawn like 5 minutes ago, so they're already capping. And I've got to kill this guy before I can... And there's another one just popped up in the view range over there. Of course, they can all see me coming from a mile away because this VFM had me lit up, and I'm in a main battle tank, and I have a lousy stealth rating. I'm going to have to kill this fella because I cannot give him my side armor. Almost all of my ERA plates are gone, by the way. Challenger, very, very strongly armed machine, obviously, particularly when it's got its explosive reactive armor packages. It's a pretty strong tank, even when it doesn't have its explosive reactive armor packages, because they've all been blown off. And look at the damage I've done. I've got to get up there, of course, regardless of who's on my flanks now, because I need to reset that cap. So this is a real uphill struggle. It's not undoable, however. The Challenger really is that strong in PvE. But I've got to actually get eyes on these tanks before I can shoot them. It's not like I'm in artillery and I can just blind fire into the cap circle. And I've won games like that in artillery, because you can blind fire in the cap circle. They're always going to spot me before I spot them, but there we go. Okay, so. Nope. He is not the one who is capping. Let's try this guy. This will be a kill. And nope, he is not the one who was capping. So let's try this Abrams. And I might have to switch to Hesh for him. Nope, he is not the one who was capping. And I have switched to Hesh just to try to get some damage done. It's got to be this Abrams. Let's do some damage to the Abrams. Did some damage to the Abrams, and he's not the one who's capping. Who is the guy with all the cap points? Back to the APF-SDS. I'm not hitting the right target here. Who's the guy I need to shoot? Is it him? It was him. Bingo. Disaster averted. I don't have to cap here, I just have to prevent them from capping. And I'm in a Challenger. And while most of my ERA plates are gone from the nose of the tank, I'm still a very strongly armored machine, so I can still do this. Okay, I took some damage. No, that wasn't any damage, that was just my tracks. Again. Strong machine. This is not a guaranteed defeat. And then they set me on fire again. And I've already used the fire extinguisher. And I could have really done without that. But I've used my consumable to replenish. And I've got the ammunition for this. The only problem, of course, is when they start respawning all around you. Oh, this just isn't fair. And I could have still gotten away with this. This is pretty desperate, but there's only one tank that's actually got shots into my rear. If I can just get my tracks back up, and if I'd started pulling back at this precise second, right now I just thought, screw it, I'm dead. But then I realised I can't actually get away with this. And if I'd started pulling back that 5 or 6 seconds sooner, I might have been able to take the shot from that tank on my flank and still won this match. But I didn't, so we lost. In a match where I did 24,000 damage and got 18 kills, and it still wasn't enough to carry my team to victory. When I saw what I'd done in this battle and realised that it wasn't my first win of the day, I nearly wept tears of pure rage and frustration. 18 kills, almost 24,000 damage. That's almost more damage than the rest of the team combined. It is more kills than the rest of the team combined. I actually got more spots than the armoured fighting vehicle. And despite doing all of that, I still only got 400 more experience than the BMP3. Armoured Warfare, why you do this to me? Have a look at the details. Have a look. See if you can just guess how much damage my armour mitigated during the course of that battle. 10,000? 15,000? Guess again. Have a look at this. Nearly 20,000. Armoured Warfare, go home, you're drunk. And it was all the fault of that Stingray, by the way. I'm laying the blame for this one completely at his feet. The blame for this one, however, is all me. I'm not entirely sure how this complete cluster actually happened. I think while queuing up in what I thought was my challenger to try to get my first win of the day, this was almost immediately after the battle that you'd just seen, I, for some reason, selected my M109A6 Paladin Tier 8 Artillery, presumably just to check whether or not I'd accumulated enough free experience to get an unlock on this thing. As you can see, I have managed to unlock both the smoke and illumination rounds on this thing. Unfortunately, I forgot to select my challenger again before I hit the button, because it's Operation Red Opossum. And you do not want to be playing artillery in Operation Red Opossum. This, for those of you who play World of Tanks, you play artillery in World of Tanks and you get Himmelsdorf, you get that kind of sinking feeling. I wish this had been Himmelsdorf, right? I don't think there's a more artillery unfriendly map in all of Armored Warfare than Operation Red Opossum. And I'm playing artillery and I'm on Operation Red Opossum. Just look at this. I'm almost constantly spotted this entire map. There is quite literally not a single place you can go in this map to avoid getting shot at when you're in artillery. And remember, when you're queuing up for a PvE battle in Armored Warfare, you can see which operation is up in whichever difficulty tier you've selected. So I've got nobody to blame for this but myself. And in fact, the only thing that kept me alive at the start of this match, if this had been a PvP game, I'd have been dead already. But the AI tends to shoot at whatever is closest to them. So initially, at least, even though I'm pretty much permanently spotted, except for, you know, those rare occasions when I'm not, they are concentrating their fire on the main battle tanks. And we do have a couple of main battle tanks here, thank God. But I just, oh, I felt so guilty. I couldn't believe I'd made such a noob mistake. And the last thing you want is to be a burden to your team. And if you pick artillery in this match, you're going to be a burden to your team. Oh my God, it's a T90NS. I've actually been in this situation, well, in the situation of those main battle tanks up ahead, with an artillery down here on the beach, desperately trying to make himself useful behind us. And all he's doing is shooting me in the back of the turret. Because he's not checking his arcs of fire. I'm going to have to go all tank destroyer here, aren't I? That's a freaking T90MS. And did you see the shot coming from the... Oh, shotgun! But yes, there he is. He just popped up on the far side of that oil container. Somebody just fired at me from the other side there, and it zoomed right over the turret. So I haven't been hit yet. And I am actually doing some damage here. Now, I certainly don't expect to do any 11,600 damage in this match. In the M19 Paladin. I'll be happy if I just survive and do some damage. My major aim for this match, after realising what a massive noob schoolboy error I've made by picking artillery on this particular match, is just to not die, not completely suck, and not be a complete burden to the team. But that's going to be a pretty tall order. What you say? Oh, I can't believe I picked artillery and hit go on this map. Why is this map so bad for artillery? Well, just look at that. fighting out there in the middle of the whole oil refinery complex, it's blind corners. It's like driving around a city map in World of Tanks in artillery. Hibbelsdorf, for example. There's nowhere you can go where you're safe. You might think, well, once you've dealt with that initial spawn, you just park your arse up here. No, they respawn up here. You can't stay here forever. You can stay here for a while, but you can't stay here forever. So, in fact, I thought I actually had a little bit longer than I did. You can see I'm sitting here and I'm thinking, okay, well, I'll drop some flares into the cap circle, help the team out, do something useful. And any second now, I'm going to get spotted. Oh, there it is, just popped up in the notification area above the map. I have just spotted an enemy vehicle, and that is the last thing you want to see when you're in artillery, in armored warfare. You have just managed to acquire direct line of sight to an enemy tier 9 main battle tank. And guess what? It's not just those two main battle tanks that have just spawned right beside me. Enemy artillery is getting involved as well. Oh, what have I done? Come on, move! Get out of there! Go faster! Oh, they've just missed me. Go faster! Get out of it! And unbelievably, somehow, I've managed to survive and get myself some hardcover between myself and that was that old Leopard 2, and I think another T-90 as well. Where are they? I'm going to have to go shotgun mode again. And don't forget, every time I fire my gun, I'm just going to drop a... Oh, there's one of them. Drop a star shell. Yeah. Well, I've spotted him, but he spotted me, and bang, that was enemy artillery firing. Now, this is actually probably, at this stage of the battle, the single best position I can be in. Enemy artillery fired from there, and I've been detected again. There he is. He's going to be aiming at me. In fact, he's hit me. But I've lit him up. I get a shot in, and if I go back, the main battle tanks are going to spot me. If I stay where I am, the artillery's going to kill me. I don't want to die. Artillery just fired and hit the building. And no, that was terrible. Oh no, there's another one in front of me. Oh God almighty. There is just nowhere to go. You can see what an absolute nightmare this map is for an artillery player. And I'll tell you what, this was not a boring game. I don't recommend you queue in artillery for Operation Red Opossum. Let's see if I can take that guy out. Take the shot. Yes, I got him. Okay, so now I just need to worry about the tanks that are in front and behind me. I don't have to worry about the tanks that are in front and behind me and the enemy artillery. So, hey, this should be fairly easy. And I'm struggling to remember from playing this match in, you know, tank destroyers and main battle tanks, where the next spawn is likely to be. And I think that where that T-90 MS spawned up in front is where they're likely to come from. So, screw that. I'm getting back up here. I'm getting some concealment between myself and whatever else is out there. There's still that T-90 MS up in front. The one that spawned up in front, just in that... Oh, no, I'm spotted again. No, what is it? What is it? Don't see me. Go away. Shoot something else. Oh, man. There he is. I can't quite... Oh, shit, I'm spotted. And he's gone. And I'm still spotted. What? Okay. Ah, Tim! Bugger off! And there it is again. In the notification area above the map. The words that you never want to see when you're in artillery, you have directly spotted, via line of sight, multiple enemy vehicles. No! No! Stop looking at me. He's still looking at me. He's got a direct line of sight. I'm still lit up. Oh, shit. Just never stops, does it? Oh, give me a break. Come on. Ah, he's hit me. No, bugger off. Two BMPT Terminators. They've got twin 30mm autocannons. Just look at somebody else. That's it. Yep, that's right. Look the other way. Look the other way. Hold it. Hold it there. Hold it there. Don't look at me. And hit them both. And hide. And don't look at me. Don't look at me. Just wait for me to reload. Nothing happening over here. There he is. There he is. He's still looking the other way. Oh. And fire. Yeah, and hit them both. The only thing that's keeping me alive here is the fact that they're occupied with the tank to their front. Oh, yay, one of them's down. Can I get the kill? Come on, reload, reload, reload. Yeah! I have no idea how I've survived this long in this match. None whatsoever. I've ended up in this match before in artillery, in the Tier 6 Palmaria, the Italian self-propelled gun. And it was literally just me running screaming from one piece of hardcover to the next. Just desperately trying to not get shot at and basically dying without doing any damage and just being a massive burden to your team. And please, guys, regardless of how amusing you may have found this particular match, do not take this as any kind of challenge, by the way. Those of you who play artillery and armoured warfare, please don't take this as some sort of challenge that Jingles wants you to go out there in artillery queuing up for Operation Red Opossum just to see how much fun you can have before your inevitable defeat. Because that just, your team will hate you. And more importantly, your team will hate me. Don't do it, really. What you're seeing here is the exception rather than the rule. Unbelievably, I've survived. And I've killed tanks. And I've actually done a, well, it was a pretty lousy amount of damage, let's be completely honest. But I'm not dead. By some miracle, I actually managed to survive Operation Red Opossum in an artillery in what, I mean, I'm calling this an epic fail, because queuing up in artillery in this map is failure of epic proportions in and of itself. But queuing up for this map in artillery and not dying? It almost made the previous match in the Challenger, where I got 18 kills and did 24,000 damage and got 21 spots and still couldn't carry my team to victory. It almost made it all worthwhile. It certainly put a smile on my face anyway. And I hope watching today's video has put a smile on your face, because that is it for today. I have been the Mighty Jingles. This has been Armoured Warfare Epic Fail. And as always, take care, and I'll catch you next time.